Let's discuss with the molar mass concept. You know that atomic mass and molecular mass we have already studied. What is atomic mass? Atomic mass is nothing but simply mass of an atom. What is the molecular mass? It simply is the mass of an molecule. Then what is the molar mass? So molar mass is defined as the mass of 1 mole of a substance in grams. You are going to measure 1 mole of substance in grams. That is the difference between molar mass and atomic mass and molecular mass. Let's see the one example. We can take the example. What is the molar mass? What is the molar mass of the carbon 12 atoms? What is the molar mass of the carbon 12 atoms? We know that 1 mole is equal to how much? 1 mole is equal to 6.023 into 10 raised to 23 of carbon 12 atom. Right? To find out the molar mass of carbon 12 atoms, we know that 1 mole is equal to 6.023 into 10 raised to 23 of carbon 12 atom. And we know that one atom of the carbon 12 atom mass is 12 amu, but when you convert into gram, because we are talking about the molar mass, we know the one carbon 12 atomic mass will be 12 gram, 12 amu, 12 atomic mass unit, but we are going to measure in the grams. Because of the molar mass, we are going to keep it in gram, then it becomes 1.66 something into 10 raised to minus 24 gram. So one carbon 12 atomic mass is 12 into 1.66 into 10 raised to minus 24 gram. Hagadre, one mole in the mass is 6.03 into 10 raised to 23 carbon 12 atomic mass is we are going to multiply with this one. That is 6.023 into 10 raised to 23 of these carbon 12 atom. Now I am going to multiply with this. These amount into this one. That is 12 into 1.66 into 10 raised to minus 24 into this 6.023 into, I mean, power number 23. So what you are going to get exact value? So you are going to multiply these values, you are going to get nearly one number. So now it becomes 12 gram. Totally, when I calculate this one, now I am going to get 12 gram. So molar mass of the carbon 12 atom is 12 gram. So molar mass of the carbon atom andrunu 12 gram, or atomic mass andrunu 12 amu. So when you are talking about the molar mass of the carbon, you should tell 12 gram. When you are talking about the atomic mass, then you should tell that 12 amu. That is called atomic mass unit. So can you consider this one? This number is same. I mean, molar mass and atomic mass, they are similar, but we are going to tell the scale. Scales are different. This scale is atomic mass scale is atomic mass unit, and molar mass scale of this one is gram. Only this much difference. We came to know that the atomic mass of carbon is 12 amu, that is atomic mass unit, but the molar mass of the carbon is 12 gram. So both are same. That means I am going to conclude that molar mass in grams is numerically equal to atomic mass or formula mass or molecular mass in unit. So not only carbon atom, some other elements also showing the same mass, that is in average atomic mass, that is in molar mass. That's you can see here. First one, carbon element, you know that its atomic mass, average atomic mass is 12.01. I can say nearly 12. In molar mass is always measured in gram per mole. So that is in 12.01. Same. And then atoms, I mean in moles, around 6.023 into 10 raised to 23 atoms. So what about hydrogen? Hydrogen is having the average atomic mass is 1.008, nearly 1. And its molar mass is also same, 1.008 in gram, that is in unit, atomic mass unit. That is here gram per mole, and here its atoms, how many atoms will be there? Same, 6.03 into 10 raised to 23. Coming to the oxygen and sodium, they will be also having the same average atomic mass and same molar mass, and atoms also same. So like this, they are numerically equal to atomic mass, formula mass and molecular mass. You know that that molar mass is numerically equal to atomic mass. But one interesting information is that the atomic mass of carbon, if you take this, you know, 12 atomic mass unit. If you take the molar mass of this carbon, it is 12 gram per mole. Number is same. Here also 12 and here also 12. But the scale or unit is very different. So compared to this atomic mass and molar mass, it's a very very less value. Because you know that one AMU value will be around 1.664 into 10 raised to minus 24 gram, but it is 12 gram. So that is also increasing the minus negative values. So by compared to this atomic mass and molar mass, it's very 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 less than this one. We have studied molar mass of the concept, right? So here we are going to study the molar masses of an elements. Suppose first I take the molar mass of the atom. So molar mass of atom of an element is given by the atomic mass only. Suppose I take first molar mass of hydrogen atom. Molar mass of hydrogen atom is nothing but same as the atomic mass of the hydrogen, that is 1.008, but due to this molar mass we are going to write in gram per mole. Similarly, molar mass of the chlorine, you know that. So molar mass of the chlorine atom is nothing but atomic mass of the chlorine. So what is atomic mass of chlorine? Chlorine is nothing but 35.5, and due to this molar mass I am going to keep it in as gram per mole. So this is a nothing but atomic mass of an element. Now these elements are also exists in the molecule form, that is it exists in hydrogen gas, it exists in chlorine gas. So these are the molar masses of the molecules of an element is written by the molar mass of an atom, that is molar mass of an atom, and it is multiplied by the how many number of atoms will be joined. So that is I show here. So first you should count this, how many atoms are here. So two atoms, that is two hydrogen. So what is the molar mass of this hydrogen? Molar mass of hydrogen is 1.008 gram per mole. So when I multiply with this one, so now it becomes 2.016, I think 16 gram per mole. So like this. What about this chlorine? So first you should count us then how many number of atoms will be there. Two atoms, and you should this number of atoms which is going to multiplied by the molar mass of an atom. So what is the molar mass of an atom of this chlorine? 35.5. So after this multiplication, I get nearly 71.0 gram per mole. So this is nothing but the molar masses of an element. This one is molar masses of a compound. So very simple definition is the sum of the atomic masses of the atoms which form the compound. I mean, if any compound is formed like water, so what happens? Then you should count the atomic masses of each of the atoms, that is hydrogen and oxygen. So I give the example for this water molecule. So it is a compound. So how many is there? The sum of the atomic masses of the atoms. So here hydrogen atom will be there and oxygen will be there. That is in the 2:1 ratio. First I take how many hydrogen atoms? Two hydrogen atoms, and its atomic mass is 1.008. Then I should add the plus, because the sum of the atomic masses. Now oxygen. How many oxygen? One oxygen, and its atomic mass will be 16. So after this multiplication, I am going to get nearly 18.016 gram per mole. So like this, this is a compound. Sum of the atomic masses of elements to form the compound. Now I can take one more example, NaCl. Very easy, NaCl. So one atom, and its atomic mass of this Na is 23.00 plus Cl, one atom. So its atomic mass is around 35.5. So after this adding, so what happens? I am going to get as a 58.5 gram per mole. So this is very simple of the molar mass of the compound. Let's solve some problems on the mole concept. So before that solving, you should see this formula. So mass and number of moles of a substance which is going to be related as n is equal to mass in grams divided by molecular mass. So if you know this one, we can solve some variety of the problems. Okay, so once again, n is nothing but number of moles, that is equal to ratio of the mass in grams divided by molecular mass. Molecular mass is nothing but mass of the molecules. First one, that based on the questions, number of moles when mass is given. So So first we can solve the first question. How many moles of silicon, SI, silicon, are present in 30.5 gram of silicon? 30.5 gram of silicon. So they have given atomic mass of silicon is equal to 28. Atomic mass of the silicon is 28 and atomic number of silicon is 14. He is going to ask how many moles. That means you are going to find out the value of N, and he has given the mass in grams. How much? So I am going to, by looking this formula, I am going to write this mass in grams. That is equal to mass in grams is 30.5 gram divided by molecular mass. Okay, he has given atomic mass. So due to this one, silicon is an element, right? So hence atomic mass and this molecular mass both are same. So I am writing 30.5 divided by 28. That is equal to, I am going to get 1.09. That is mole. So how? So finally, so 1.09 moles of an silicon are present in 30.5 gram of the silicon. You can understand like this. Let's go for the variety of second problem. How many grams of sulfate? I mean, he is going to ask now how many grams. That is, you should find out this one. Okay, how many grams of sulfate? That is SO4 2 minus ions are present in 0.5 mole of the sulfate, and he has given, mole has given, and molecular mass, that is mass has given, individual atoms, and you should find out the mass in grams. Okay, so just before going to this one, we are going to find out the molecular mass or formula mass of the sulfate. So here we are going to find out the formula mass or molecular mass of the sulfate. So here how many atoms will be the sulfur? One atom. So whatever its atomic mass is, has given the value as 32. So just I am going to add 32 plus, because it sum of the atomic masses, right? And how many oxygen are there? 4 oxygen. Hence 4 into has given the value 16. So how much? 32 plus 4 into 16, that is 64. 64 plus 32 is nothing but 96. Now we got the this molecular mass or formula mass. Then you can apply this formula here. N is equal to how much? Has given 0.5. 0.5 into molecular mass, that is nothing but formula mass. We found out this one, 96. That is equal to mass in grams. We are going to find out the mass in grams. So how much after this multiplication, 0.5 into 96, we are going to get 48 grams. So 48 grams of an sulfate ions are present in 0.5 mole of the sulfate. Next variety of problem, that is when mass of substance when mole has given, because in the question mole is going to give now, so we should find out the grams. Okay, so question is, how many grams of copper, that is Cu, are present in 2.55 mole of the copper? I mean, this one 2.55 mole is nothing but moles has given, and you should find out the once again mass in grams. So what is the formula here? The formula is, so N has given, how much has given? 2.55 into, because we are going to find out this mass in grams, so N into molecular mass. Okay, so what is the molecular mass of this copper is? So 63.5. So after this multiplication of this 2.55 into 63.5, we are going to get 162 grams. So hence 162 grams of an copper are present in 2.55 mole of the copper. In this variety of problem, you can see the question, calculate the mass of one atom of the oxygen. He is going to ask only one atom of the oxygen, and he has given the atomic mass, that is 16 gram per mole, and Avogadro number is 6.023 into 10 to the 23 per mole. So here Avogadro number has given. So by looking this formula, so this is not going to match up with this problem, right? Because he has given Avogadro number, and he has not given the moles also in the question, and moles value has not given. So that's why for this type of problems, when Avogadro number has given, this problem is not work out. So we are going to use this formula, M is equal to M divided by Na. What is this M? So here M is nothing but mass of an one atom. We are going to find out the mass of an one atom, and this M is nothing but molecular mass. molecular mass. You know that molecular mass has given, and molecular mass, since oxygen is an element, therefore atomic mass as well as molecular mass both are equal. Hence molecular mass of the oxygen is, molecular mass of the oxygen has given 16 gram per mole, and has given our number, that is Na. Na is equal to 6.023 into 10^23. Just to substitute the values, so what will the value of M? M has given 16 gram per mole divided by, and 6.023 into 10^23 per mole. So this per mole and this per mole is going to cancel. So remaining is 16 gram divided by 6.023 into 10^23. So I am going to write here. So 16 divided by 6.023 is going to get as 2.56 into 10^-22. Remaining as it is gram, because this mole and numerator mole and denominator mole has cancelled. Remaining is 2.56 into 10^-22 gram. So this much of gram we are going to calculate as one atom of the oxygen. We are calculated the one atom of an oxygen.